LED Box V2 is a Wi-Fi controller for addressable LED strips. It has a button, infrared receiver, and an inbuilt digital microphone. Since it's fully compatible with WLED firmware, it is a perfect choice for ambient lighting in your room, bias lighting behind the screen that wirelessly synchronizes to colors of the displayed image, or a sound reactive functionality that sets a party mood when playing music. The module is compatible with most addressable LED strips, including both 5V and 12V versions. Since the input barrel socket is directly connected to the output through a fuse, make sure that you only connect the power supply with a stable DC voltage matching the LED strip's requirement. Also, make sure that your power supply can provide enough current for your strip type, length, and application. The longer the strip and brighter the color, the more power it will try to draw. For example, I'm using a 5V WS2812 strip, so the output from my power supply needs to be 5V. This particular strip can range from 35 to 55 mA per LED, so if I want to power let's say 3 meters and the strip has 30 LEDs per meter, my power supply needs to be able to provide approximately 5 amps in the absolute worst case. However, keep in mind that even though the barrel socket is rated for 5 amps, the JST-SM connector, commonly used on strips, is officially rated only for 3 amps. To safely provide enough power to your strip, you might need to do a power injection where you branch out the power lines before the module and connect them directly to the strip using thick enough cables that can handle the maximum current you expect. When using long strips, you might still experience a color shift towards the end. This is due to the voltage drop caused by strip's resistance. To solve this, you can inject power to the strip repeatedly every few meters. For battery operation, you must ensure that the battery pack can provide sufficient continuous discharge current. However, compared to regulated power supply, batteries usually cannot output a stable voltage across the full discharge cycle. Therefore, it is important to use battery pack with larger nominal voltage and then use a step-down converter to regulate and stabilize the output voltage required for the strip. For example, to power a 5V strip using a lithium-ion battery which has 3.7 volts nominal and 4.2 volts fully charged voltage, I would need at least two of them in series to get above 5V and then use a step-down converter to regulate it to a stable 5V output. My 50W step-down module can handle input 8 to 23 volts and provide a stable 5V output at maximum 10 amps, so I can for example use a 12.8 volt battery from Soundbox and my strip will work fine. You can find more information about the modules on my website. The links are in the description together with a link to Tindi where you can buy the fully assembled modules. Thank you for watching.